Dear students, today we are going to continue chapter 4, measurement of angles, exercise 4.1. Question number 11. A railroad curve is to be laid out on a circle. What radius should be used? If the track is to change direction by 25 degree in a distance of 40 meters. So there is one circle. On this circle we have to lay out one railway track or railway road. Means एक circle है, circle के ऊपर हमको एक railway track बिछाना है. So उस railway track की radius क्या होगी? If on 40 meter distance this track is changing the direction by 25 degree. वो जो ट्रैक है वो 25 डिग्री पर अपनी डायरेक्शन को चेंज करता है. सो व्हाट शुड बी द रेडियस ऑफ दैट ट्रैक? सो सपोज दिस इज वन सर्कल एंड लेड आउट वन ट्रैक ऑन दिस सर्कल. सपोज दिस इज द ट्रैक, this is railway track. This distance is 40 meter. After running this 40 meter, this track is changing its direction by 25 degree. So this angle is 25 degree. This is 25 degree angle. So what should be the radius of this track? Radius of this track we can consider r. So this is the radius. This is radius and this 40 meter, this distance is length of arc. L is equal to 40 meter. And this angle theta is given 25 degree. So we have to find out this radius r. So length of arc L is equal to 40 meter. So length of arc L is equal to 40 meter. Theta is equal to 25 degree. This angle is given in degree. We have to convert this degree into radian first. Since 180 degree is equal to pi radian. Therefore, 1 degree is equal to 1 pi by 180 radian. Radian. So multiply by here this 25 into pi by 180 radian. This many radians. Simplify this. 5 5s are 25, 5 3s are 15, 3 5 6s are 30. 5 pi by 36 radian. So theta is equal to 5 pi by 36 radian. This is the radian measure. Now we have one relation. Since theta is equal to L upon R, where L is the length of arc, R radius, and theta is the central angle, which is in radian. So here radius of track we have to find out. So R is equal to question mark. So here L, theta and r, three things. For this three things we have one relation. Since theta is equal to L upon r, where theta is the angle, L length of arc, and r radius. So substitute the value of theta and L and calculate the value of r, which implies theta is equal to 5 pi अपॉन 36 रेडियन, लेंथ ऑफ आर्क 40 मीटर एंड रेडियस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस, सो आर इज इक्वल टू 40 इंटू 36, 40 इंटू 36 अपॉन 5 पाई. Now, this pi we can put 22 upon 7. So, 40 into 36 upon 5 into 22 upon 7. We can write this 7 here. Now, simplify this. 5 8 ja 40, 2 4 ja 8. 2 11 जा 36, 2 11 जा 22, which is equal to 4 into 36 into 7 upon 11. Simplify this. Four into 36 into 7, 1008. Divided by 11. Divide this by 11. 1008 upon 11 is equal to 91.636 and more digits. This is up to 3 digits. So this third digit is 6. It is greater than 5. So add 1 in this previous digit. So it is 91.64 meter approx. This is approx 91.6 meter approx. This is the answer. The radius of track should be 91.64 meter approximately. Question number 12. Find the length at which a distance of 5280 meter will subtend an angle of 1 radian at the eye. So we have to find out the length of arc which at a distance of 5280 meter will subtend an angle 1 minute at the eye of the observer. So suppose this is the eye of the observer. Eye of the observer, and this is this length of arc. This length we have to find out, which making angle 1 minute at the eye of the observer. Suppose this angle is 1 minute and at a distance of 5280 meter. So this length we have to find out at a distance of 5280 meter from the eyes of the observer, and this angle is, this length is making angle 1 minute at the eye of the observer. So this 5280 meter is the radius. This is radius. And this length is length of arc L. And this is theta, 1 minute. So radius is equal to 5280 meter. L is equal to, we have to find out length of arc, and theta is given 1 minute. So for using the formula, theta is equal to L upon R, we require the angle theta in radian. So we have to convert this 1 minute into radian. So first convert this 1 minute into degree, then we can convert degree into radian. So we have the conversion. Since 60 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 1 डिग्री, 60 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 1 डिग्री और 1 डिग्री इज इक्वल टू 60 मिनट. सो देयरफॉर 1 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 1 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 1/60 डिग्री, 1/60 डिग्री. This is 1 minute. This is 1 minute. So multiply by 1/60 for converting it into degree. So which is equal to 1 into 1/60 degree. This is degree. So it is 1/60 degree. 1/60 degree. Now convert this degree into radian. So again, since pi radian is equal to 180 degree, since 180 degree is equal to pi radian, so therefore 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian, pi by 180 radian. So multiply here by pi by 180. So 160, 1/60 into pi by 180 radian. This much radian, or we can multiply this or leave it as it is. This much radians. Now we can apply the formula by using theta is equal to L/R. Theta is equal to 1/60. Into pi by 180, this is radian, is equal to L, length of arc we have to find out, so it is L, and radius is 5280 meter. Now simplify this, which implies by cross multiplying this pi into 5280 upon 60 into 180 is equal to L. So here this pi we can substitute 22/7. 22/7 into 5280 upon 60 into 180 is equal to L. Now simplify this. This 0 and 0 cancelled, and 2 1 2 2 1 2 2 9 18, this 60 by 2 2 3 6 and 0, and this 5 28 by 2 2 2 4 2 6 12 and 2 4 8 264. Again we can cancel this 264 by 30, this by this 30 divided by 2 15 times, and this 264 we can cancel by 2, 2 1 2 2 3 6 2 2 4, 132 times. So finally L is equal to 11 into 132 upon 15 into 7 into 15 into 9, So L is equal to 11 into 130, 2. This is 1452. So divide this 1452 by 945, 1.536. So this third digit is 6, which is greater than 5. So we can add 1 here. So L is equal to 1.54 meter approx. This is the length of arc. 1.54 meter approximately. Question number 13. A wheel makes 360 revolutions per minute. Through how many radians does it turn in 1 second? There is one wheel which makes 360 revolutions per minute. In 1 minute, it is making 360 revolutions. So through how many radians does it turn in 1 second? So 1 second mein wo kitna radian turn hoga? We have to find out the angle in 1 second in radian. So 360 revolutions per minute. In 1 minute, number of revolutions, is equal to 360. In 1 minute, number of revolutions is equal to 360. That is, in 60 seconds, number of revolutions is equal to 360. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So it will make 360 revolution in 60 seconds. Therefore, number of revolutions in 1 second. Is equal to 360 divided by 60. Simplify this. This 0 cancelled. 6 ja 36, or we can say 6 revolutions. So wheel will turn 6 revolutions in 1 second. So we have to find out how many radians in 1 second. In 1 second, 6 revolutions. So when the wheel completes one complete revolution, then how many radians are degrees? In one complete revolution, it will cover 360 degree or 2 pi radians. Since in one revolution, wheel makes 2 pi radians, 2 pi radian. In one revolution, wheel makes 2 pi radians. Therefore, in how many revolutions? 6 revolutions. Therefore, in 6 revolutions, wheel will make 2 pi into 6. That is 12 pi radian. So in 6 revolution made by wheel in 1 second, number of revolutions in 1 second is equal to 6 revolution. So here we have got, in 6 revolution, this wheel will make 12 pi radian. so that is are therefore number of radians turned by wheel in 1 second is equal to 12 pi radians. Number of radians turned by wheel in 1 second is equal to 12 pi radians. Question number 14. Find the angle in radians through which a pendulum swings if its length is 75 cm and tip describe an arc of length 10 cm, 15 cm and 21 cm. There is one pendulum which swings and making the angle. So that angle we have to find out, and the length of pendulum is given 75 cm and its tip describe an arc of length 10 cm. So in how many radians through which a pendulum swings, wo pendulum kitne angle se swing hota hai, that angle we have to find out in radian. So for this, suppose this is one pendulum. This is one pendulum. Its length is given 75 cm. And it describes its tip, describe an arc suppose in this way its tip describe this arc. So this arc making angle here, this angle is theta. This we have to find out. Its length is given 75 cm, length of pendulum, and this arc length 10 cm in first case. So we can consider this length of arc. So we can consider this length of pendulum as radius, this length of arc, this is L, and this angle we have to find out in radian. So length of pendulum length of pendulum is equal to 75 cm, which we can take radius of circle. First, length of arc L is equal to 10 cm, and this angle we have to find out, theta is equal to question mark. Okay, for finding this theta in radian, we have direct relation. Since theta is equal to L upon R radian, which is equal to L is equal to 10 and R is equal to 75. You can cancel this by 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5, 5 5s are 25, which is equal to 2 upon 15 radian. 2 upon 15 radian. 2 upon 15 radian. This is the first part. Now, second, if this length of arc is 15 cm, then what is this theta? Second, if L is equal to 15 cm, so again, theta is equal to L upon R. Length of arc 15, radius 75, 15 ones are 15, 15 fives are 75. So this is 1 upon 5 radians, 1 upon 5 radian. एंड वन मोर पार्ट थर्ड वन लेंथ ऑफ आर्क इज 21 सेंटीमीटर. थर्ड वन एल इज इक्वल टू 21 सेंटीमीटर. थीटा इज इक्वल टू एल अपॉन आर दिस मच रेडियन. एल 21 एंड रेडियस 75. कैंसिल दिस बाय 3 7 जा 21, 3 2 जा 6, 3 5 जा 15, 7/25 रेडियन. 7/25 रेडियन. दिस इज द आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. द रेडियस ऑफ अ सर्कल इज 30 सेंटीमीटर. फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ आर्क ऑफ दिस सर्कल इफ द लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड ऑफ द आर्क इज 30 सेंटीमीटर. सो द रेडियस ऑफ सर्कल इज गिवन 30 सेंटीमीटर एंड लेंथ ऑफ एन आर्क ऑफ दिस सर्कल इफ द लेंथ ऑफ द कॉर्ड ऑफ आर्क इज 30 सेंटीमीटर. लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड इज गिवन 30 सेंटीमीटर. सो हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द लेंथ ऑफ आर्क. सो ड्रॉ वन सर्कल. सपोज दिस इज सर्कल. इट्स रेडियस इज 30 सेंटीमीटर एंड द लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड इज ऑल्सो 30 सेंटीमीटर. सपोज दिस इज लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड ऑफ आर्क. दिस इज 30 सेंटीमीटर एंड दिस इज रेडियस. This is also radius. So this is also 30 centimeter and this is 30 centimeter. So what is the length of this arc? Length of this arc. This length of arc. This length of arc we have to find out. रेडियस ऑफ सर्कल 30 सेंटीमीटर. द लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड ऑफ दिस आर्क. दिस इज द कॉर्ड. लाइन सेगमेंट ज्वाइनिंग एनी टू पॉइंट्स ऑफ अ सर्कल इज कॉल्ड कॉर्ड. सो दिस लेंथ ऑफ कॉर्ड इज 30 सेंटीमीटर. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दिस लेंथ ऑफ आर्क. सो फॉर फाइंडिंग दिस लेंथ ऑफ आर्क एल we require this central angle, this angle theta. So we can label this O A B. So here for finding this L, first we require this theta. So notice this figure. All the three sides, this 30 centimeter, this 30 centimeter, and this 30 centimeter. So this triangle OAB is an equilateral triangle. And each angle of equilateral triangle is 60 degrees. So this angle will be 60 degrees. Now write this. Radius of circle OA is equal to OB is equal to 30 centimeter. Is equal to, we can take radius r. Length of cord AB is equal to 30 centimeter. So clearly OA is equal to OA is equal to OB is equal to AB. All the three sides of this triangle are equal. Therefore, triangle AOB is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. And we know each angle of equilateral triangle is, that is 60 degree. Angle AOB is equal to 60 degree is equal to, we can take theta. But this theta we require in radian. So that is theta is equal to 60 degree is common angle. We can write direct pi by 3 radian. This is pi by 3 radian. So theta is equal to pi by 3 radian or 60 degree. Now we can apply the formula here for finding this length of arc. Since theta is equal to L upon R. So theta is pi by 3 radian or 60 degree. L, we considered this length of arc is L and R is 30 centimeter. This is 30. By cross multiplying this, so pi into 30 upon 3 is equal to L. 3 banja 3 and 0, 10 times. That is L is equal to 10 pi centimeter. This is the length of arc. Answer 10 pi centimeter. This length of arc will be 10 pi centimeter. So it's enough for today. The remaining things of this chapter we will see in next video. Okay, bye.